I'd like you all to give a very, very warm welcome this evening to your host, Martel Maxwell.
Thank you, Kezia, who I'm sure you'll agree looks like she could be one of the models. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm delighted to be here. Freedom Hair Experience would like to welcome you to the face of Freedom 2010. This very special event features 12 young hopefuls who are here tonight to win a contract with Colours Model Agency, as well as a £500 top prize and a photo shoot to kickstart their modelling career. The women and men you will see this evening, sorry, I should have said, we also have this evening a very special group of ladies and gentlemen who we have called the Maggies Models. The women and men you will see this evening, modelling fashion by New Look and by Debenhams, have all survived or are living with cancer, and all proceeds from tonight's show will be donated to local cancer charities. There's the Maggie Centre, Breast Cancer Care, Chemo Day Ward, and Ninewell's Cancer Campaign. Tonight, we also have a very special performer, Kit Clark, performing and a hair demonstration from the team at Freedom Hair Experience, led by Irving Miskell-Reid and Mary Forbes. And I've come up specially for this evening. Mention the word Dundee or brilliant charities like this and I'm on the first train. As this is a modelling competition, we must of course have judges. And I'm very special judges they are too. All from the world of hair, beauty and fashion. Allow me to introduce the judges to the stage. Please give a warm Dundee welcome to Off Miguel Hair Experience, Don Miguel. And here we have Lee Ferguson. Karen Bowen. And from Colours Modelling Agency, Alison Bruce. Thank you to our judges. Are you just standing there or are we taking seats? Just stand there, it's fine. Now the reason we're here tonight is not only to find Dundee's next top model, but to raise money for some very special charities along the way. Before we, as you can imagine, they're in high demand in London, New York, Paris and Rome, but for one night only, they've agreed to come right here on the stage in Fat Sam's. Please welcome them to the stage, our Maggie's Models.
Thank you.
the stairs saying, there's always bloody one, it had to be me. It's lovely to see so many faces in the crowd. And when the lights went up there, I saw my pal Susan from school. Doreen gives a whoop whoop, Doreen. My mum, my sister Holly, Jenny, Susan, they're all here. Lovely to see you all, and thank you all for coming tonight. You too are the stars of the show, for giving up your Sunday and giving so generously to amazing charities. Now, we have another group of brave women who were not able to feature in our show this evening, but they have been to Freedom Hair Experience for a brand new look. And trust me, I've seen them backstage. They're looking awfully bonny. Here to present the models from the evening are Irvin Miskell-Reid, Mary Forbes, and the team from Freedom Hair Experience.
Hi, I must say, so you've seen you since we got started.
I know.
Yes, it's a long time.
I kissed his son once.
He's somewhere in the audience, he never mentioned that. Anyway, we've been working on the heads tonight, the models and stuff, for a couple of weeks now, rehearsing. And it's great to see such an audience. Thanks very much for coming out. Well, we have some models now of the girls who maybe moved to the side. This is the team from Freedom. Lisa, no, come on. Could we have our first model on? Who couldn't take part in the fashion event that you've just seen. However, we wanted to do their hair anyway. And it's a camera. Now you can see what we've done. It was very short anyway. We just put some colour through it, and it was just to improve it. It was short, and I think you preferred it short. We felt that it would be better if she grew it, which I think she is going to do, growing it a little bit. But she couldn't take part. But she was very brave to come up here anyway. That's what Helen was like. You can put the lights up there, lads, if you can. Just to see what we've done. You can't see it now, but it was really quite white. We've just given it some subtle colour. We've put some dark, as most people, when people go white, it tends to be very unevenly white. It doesn't go pure white. That's a myth. You get that when you're much older. Very few people just go evenly white. It's usually a bit tortoiseshell. And that's the way Helen's hair was. It was dark at the back, so what we did was put fine thread, dark highlights through the front to balance it out. And again, Helen's going to grow her hair. And it grows from the crown, we're going to grow that down. And again, thanks very much for coming up. Okay, thank you. Lynn before, and what we did was the haircut, which we also coloured it. And we wanted to keep it long. We didn't take anything from the front, but we gave her a new look. It's a new look for her. I'm not saying it's a particularly groundbreaking look, hairdressing-wise, but it's a new look for Lynn. Hopefully she likes it. We coloured it. We put several different colours through it to give it the shine that you're seeing. Okay, thank you. And this is my little daughter. So, thanks very much. Really enjoyed the show. Again, we coloured Linda's hair. We didn't want to take it any shorter. We don't necessarily cut hair, but what, you don't mind me saying, but what was really salt and pepper, wasn't it? You know, with grey, there was a mixture of grey going through it. But to camouflage that, we did two different colours of lights. Both of them were darker. There was only three shades apart. So it tends to camouflage and diffuse the white in the hair. It doesn't have to be all over colour. In fact, we very rarely do a blanket colour. That's the sort of stuff that you go and do that in from Asda, from the chemists. We don't do that. Any of our colours usually have a few colours added because it's much more natural. Thank you, and we hope you enjoy the rest of the show. So, you can see us after, okay? And we'll go off now and you see the rest of the show. Thanks very much.
No, thank you, Irvin. Thank you very much. Caught me blethering there. I'm sure you'll agree they all looked absolutely wonderful. Let's give them another round of applause! Now, let's get down to the very serious business of meeting the finalists for the Face of Freedom 2010.